Now let's look at an example on the topic of unsymmetrical curved moving plate. So the question says we have a jet of water which has a velocity of 20 meters per second. So this is V1. It strikes a curved vane which is moving with a velocity of 10 meters per second. So this is U1. The jet makes an angle of 20 degrees with the direction of motion of vane at inlet and leaves at an angle of 130 degrees with the direction of motion of vane. Okay, at the outlet. So find the vane angles so that the water enters and leaves without shock, and the work done per second per unit weight of water striking the vane per second. So for this question, I have already made the inlet and the outlet velocity triangles. So if you look at the inlet velocity triangle, V1 is given to you as 20. U1 is given to you as 10. The angle of the jet with the direction of motion is 20. So alpha becomes 20. Let's write down this information. So V1 is 20 meters per second. Alpha becomes 20 degrees and U1 is 10 meters per second, and I will say that this is equal to U2 as well. Okay. Now the angle at the outlet of the vane with the direction of the motion is 130. So this is the direction of motion, this is the outlet velocity of the jet, and the angle between this line and this line is 130. So what would be the value of beta? The value of beta would be this angle. This is equal to this because of the transversal and the parallel lines. You will have 180 minus 130, which is 50. So beta is 50, alpha is 20. We have to find the vane angles. Vane angles are theta and phi. So I have to find out theta, which is the vane angle at the inlet, and the vane angle at the outlet is phi. So these two things have to be found out. Okay, let's start with the IVT. What is the value of tan theta? The value of tan theta in triangle BCD is VF1 by CD. Isn't it? So tan theta is VF1 upon CD. CD is what? VW1 minus U1. You will have VW1 minus U1. Now what is VF1? VF1 in terms of V1 is sine component, isn't it? So VF1 is V1 sine alpha. So it becomes 20 sine 20 degrees. So 20 sine 20. So this value of VF1 would be 6.84 meters per second. And if you find out VW1, it is the cos component of V1. So VW1, it will be V1 cos 20. So this becomes 20 cos 20, isn't it? So it will be 18 point something. 18.79 meters per second. So you have VW1 and you have VF1. And you already have U1, so you can easily find out theta now. So from this equation, I'll get theta is equal to tan inverse of VF1, which is 6.84, upon 18.79 minus 10. So when you solve this, the value of theta comes out to be 37 degrees, 53 minutes. So this is the value of theta. Okay, now if I use this triangle again, and let me use the value of sine theta. So sine theta will be VF1 by VR1, because now we know VF1, we know theta, and we can find out VR1. So sine theta, that is sine of 37 degrees, 53 minutes, is equal to VF1, which is 6.84, divided by VR1, which is to be found out. Okay, so from this equation, I will get the value for VR1, which is 6.84 by this sine. It will be 11.14 meters per second. Now it the water is entering and leaving without shock, means there is no loss. So VR1 will be equal to VR2. So this is equal to VR2 as well. So we have now got the value of VR2. So now we are moving towards the OVT, because we have found out the blade angle or the vane angle at inlet theta. Now comes the time to calculate the value of phi. Right, so we have VR2. Let's name this triangle. So this is E, this is F, this is G, and this is H. Let me take the triangle EFG. From this triangle, I can say that VR2 upon this angle, sine of this angle. So VR2 upon sine of 180 minus beta is equal to, if I take U2 as the velocity vector, upon the sine of the opposite angle. So this is the angle I want to have. Now this angle is equal to, now if you look at this angle, this entire angle from this line to this line is beta. And if you look at this, this angle is phi. So if I subtract phi from the bigger angle beta, I get this angle. So this is sine of beta minus phi. Now I know the value of VR2, which is 11.14. Okay, I know the value of U2, which is equal to U1, and it is 10 meters per second. Beta is also known to us as 50, and it is an acute angle, right? So from here I can find out the value for phi very easily. So phi eventually will come out to be around 6 degrees and 34 minutes. So this is the blade angle at the outlet. So now we have found out the vane angles or blade angles at the entry and the exit. So at entry it was around 37 degrees, and at outlet it is about 6 degrees 34 minutes. Right, so we are done with the first part. The second part is work done per second per unit weight of water striking the vane per second. Again, it's a very straightforward formula application. So that becomes 1 by G VW1 plus minus VW2 into U. Now plus minus, will it be plus or will it be minus? It will be plus because this is less than 90. That's an acute angle. So I will not be using minus over here. So when you put in the values, you will get 20.24 Newton meter per Newton of work done. So this is the second part of the question. Okay, so you saw that how you have to use the trigonometry and the knowledge of the triangles to solve questions on this concept. So I hope you got this. Now let's move on to the next video and look at one more example on the same concept.